This next two-part exercise will take place on a discussion board that is specifically dedicated to this activity only. The space will be anonymous, but it will be viewable to others in the course. To recap from the beginning of the module, please feel free to pass on any prompt at any time if you feel it's triggering or otherwise unproductive. Do not include any identifying details about yourself, other individuals, or any specific setting. Respect other people's experiences and speak from your own experience. The first prompt is to briefly describe an incident that you have seen, experienced, or heard about in your research and teaching environment that was not inclusive or welcoming. And here's a member of our development team describing how to navigate the discussion board.
You'll find the discussion board using a tool called Padlet embedded below. As you can see here in the lower right-hand corner, you'll find a pink button with a plus sign to add a new thread. When you click that button, a new white thread with a title section and a body section will appear in the upper left-hand corner. You can then enter a short title and a description of the incident you're sharing in the body section.
A day or so after you've responded to the first prompt, go back to the discussion board and look at your incident and the other incidents that have been shared. We now want you to consider a second prompt. What small actions could have made this go differently? Think about small actions from many perspectives, such as bystanders, colleagues, the lab advisor, the individual in question, the teacher or mentor, or any others, especially considering roles and identities that you might be carrying or will carry. Add your thoughts around the original description of the incident as a reply to that original. And here's a member of our development team once again to show you how to comment on the discussion board.
In the same discussion board, to respond to a thread, click in the box titled Add Comment, and you will be able to add your response. To submit your response, either hit Enter or use the arrow button on the right side of the comment box.
One final note. If after reading the responses on the discussion board, other questions or reflections arise for you, that's great. But do include these in your private reflections in the space provided below. While these reflections might be very useful for you, we would like to keep the discussion board clean and focused, and only for sharing incidences and possible responses to that incident. And once more, only share as you wish and respect others' perspectives.